Once the RC circuit has been set up, you are ready to take measurements with the oscilloscope. Turn on the oscilloscope. Start by pressing the default button, just to remove any settings that might be left over from the previous use of the oscilloscope. Turn on the function generator. Select the square wave. Adjust the output voltage to about halfway, and set the frequency to somewhere between 3 and 500 Hz. Adjust the vertical and horizontal display knobs until you get a signal that looks something like this on the screen. Go ahead and adjust the vertical to mostly fill the screen with your signal. Notice, as I change the output frequency on the function generator, the display on the oscilloscope doesn't change. This is because the frequency of the square wave is long compared to the charging time of the capacitor. Here, the capacitor is fully discharged, and here it's charged. Adjust the output level on the function generator, and the ground adjust on the oscilloscope until you can get the top and bottom of your signal lined up with some convenient lines on the oscilloscope. Then I'll count the divisions between the bottom and the top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I want to know how long it takes for the signal to go from uncharged to halfway charged. The problem is, with this setting, the time that it takes to charge is really small compared to the time scale of the display, so I need to stretch it out some. I do this with the horizontal adjust knob. I expand the signal so that I can make it as big as possible and get both the beginning of the charging and the time it takes to charge up to halfway, up 3 divisions. I'm going to adjust it back to where it's at a convenient line on the oscilloscope, then look to see where it crosses at 3 divisions above where it started. I'd like to stretch it out as far as possible for the most accurate measurement. So I'll adjust it one click farther and move the signal over so that the point where it's starting charging is at a convenient measuring spot. That's probably as far as I can stretch it out, so I'm going to make my measurement at this setting. And I'll count the divisions. There's about 10 of them. Read it as accurately as you can. Now multiply the number of divisions by the time per division, which you can read off right here. You have now measured the time for the voltage to go from the low value to halfway to the high value. We will call this time T1/2. Your lab will explain how T1/2 relates to the time constant, tau. Compare your measurement to the time constant you would expect for the capacitor and resistor you are using. If it's not somewhat close, take your measurement again and compare again. Adjust the horizontal and vertical knobs so that you have a good display on the screen, and vertically it covers about half the screen. Adjust the horizontal knobs so that you have a few waves, but not too many. The charging time is so quick that it essentially looks like a square wave, and we want to see it look a little more rounded. So let's change the function generator to the 5000 range. Adjust the horizontal display until you have a
few waves displayed. Adjust the vertical height and the vertical positioning so that it takes up less than half the screen and is placed in the upper half of the oscilloscope. Push the number 2 button to turn on channel 2. You can read the volts per division here. Adjust the voltage on channel 2 to match the volts per division on channel 1. And adjust the positioning knob to move channel 2 into the lower half of the oscilloscope screen. The function generator voltage is measured relative to the function generator ground. In our diagram, that's from the far right side to the far left side. The oscilloscope measures the voltages for the capacitor and the resistor from the oscilloscope ground. That is from the middle of our diagram. So the capacitor is measured to the left, and the resistor is measured to the right. We want to measure both of them to the left in the same direction as the function generator. Fortunately, there's a fix for that. We are able to invert the signal on either channel. Then, channel 2 will be measured from the right to the left. The channel 2 menu should be selected, but if it's not, just press the channel 2 button on and off. Then press the button that says Next Page. Then the button that says Invert, press it on. Note that while the capacitor is charging and its voltage goes high, the resistor's voltage spikes and then goes low again. Then, when the capacitor discharges, the voltage goes low on the resistor. If we were to add the voltage across the resistor to the voltage across the capacitor, we would get the voltage across the function generator. The voltage across the function generator is a square wave. Push the math button in between the two channels. We need to adjust our added signal to the same volts per division as our other two signals. So we use this button that says Scale, and we push the button, and then the little blue curvy arrow on the button means that this is the adjust knob. Adjust it to the same volts per division as the two inputs. By default, this machine adds channel 1 to channel 1, and we want to add channel 1 to channel 2. So go ahead and press Source B and select channel 2. If it doesn't look exactly like a square wave, that's because there are inductances and capacitances in the oscilloscope and in the function generator that cannot be accounted for.